election coverage. We are broadcasting live tonight from the Sydney seat of Grayndler, the Iron Throne of Sydney's inner west. We've just heard from the Greens member who's fighting for the long-held Liberal seat from one very absent Anthony Albanese.
I think it's a Labor-held seat, last time I checked.
Sorry, what did I say Greens-held seat?
Liberal-held.
Liberal-held seat. Wow, so many Freudian slips tonight.
You might actually get Albo calling in.
Yeah, well, let's hope so. Fingers crossed. But joining me to pick apart the absence of Albo are two former staffers. We've got Sean Kelly, we've got Lachlan Harris. Let me go straight to you, Sean. I mean, you guys both know Albo very well. I'll start with you, though. There are 200 of his constituents here tonight. Bit rude of him not to show up, wouldn't you say?
Oh, difficult question. I'm sure Albo is busy campaigning around the country.
Mine on here, indeed.
I'm not Albo's spokesperson. I'm good. A responsible journalist.
Good point. We thought.
I think you should have come.
We'd throw
I'm
you that
go popular.
Fair enough.
Albo is a straight shooter, you know what I mean? I don't know. He could absolutely have had some killer event on, I don't know. But if he didn't, it was a mistake and he should have come.
Do you think it's because he's busy planning to topple Shorten after he loses the election this
Saturday? Literally, it's like if he does really, really well tonight, he kind of he has a minor benefit, but if he really makes a huge mistake, it can have a major, and so he's just, he can have a major influence. And so his view would be, is the risks outweigh the rewards. Now, I think he's a good enough and a pro enough that there is no risk, but he's obviously made a different decision tonight.
Labor's not looking great. I mean, the bookies, who, let's be honest, are the best predictor of an election outcome, they've got the Libs walking it in, right? Labor's paying $7. We check, because there's a couple of gamblers in our office, let me just put it that way. We know that Labor loves a good coup. Surely there's talk within the party about replacing Shorten.
Look, I don't know. One thing I'd say about every election, one person gets it right and someone gets it wrong. So every now and then it's the pollsters who get it wrong and then the bookies, and the bookies are perfect. And then it's the opposite. The Brexit campaign, the bookies got it totally wrong. The UK election in 2015, the bookies got it right, the pollsters got it wrong. So it's not at all clear from those things. I think, if you're asking me who do I think is going to win, like I think the bookies are probably on the money tonight.
Okay.
And what will determine whether or not there's a coup is how badly we lose by, effectively, how badly Labor loses by.
Okay, Sean, what do you think of Jim Casey and what are his chances?
I think Jim's doing very, very well. I think he's making the case. He was right to turn up tonight. But I think... Look, I think Jim will take this seat in an election, in two elections. I think he's unlikely to win this election. And that's partly because Albo retains huge name recognition in this seat. I mean, I lived in this seat until very recently when they redrew the boundaries, which I'm very angry about. And people know Albo. And, of course, there was a preference deal as well, which has effectively ended the Greens' chances here.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't the only seat that's looking likely to sway a little bit more green. We've got Batman, we've got Wills. They're also under threat from the Greens. Why do you think Labor's hemorrhaging votes to them?
Yeah, it's interesting you said under threat from the Greens. I think Labor's biggest threat in seats like Grayndler is the Labor Party, unfortunately. The reality is... And it's really simple. Labor has failed to adopt and adapt and modernise itself. And so we are effectively cutting off our leg in seats like this. Like, we have to change, we have to rebuild ourselves, become much more inclusive and democratic, and then we'll win seats like this. Albo got a 55% 2PP here in 2007. Two elections later, it was almost 10 points lower. That was because of what Labor did to itself. So Labor has to earn the right to represent people in these seats by changing and evolving.
And the central poll out today has a quarter of voters voting neither Labor or Liberal. What do you think's turning them off? Are they too similar?
Look, I think... absolutely. I think that you're seeing this all around the world. I think there's two things going on. I think in some parts of the country where you get these post-industrial economies, people's wages haven't gone up for years. They are really, really angry about both parties, about pretty much every orthodoxy you name, economics, major political parties, and they're going to vote independent. Then I think in places like Grayndler, they'll mostly vote for people like Nick Xenophon, but some people who I don't think the people in this room would find that attractive, like a Jackie Lambie or a Lazarus or a Darren Hinch or a Pauline Hanson. Then I think you've also got seats like this where the Labor Party effectively is, by failing to adopt and adapt to the reality of the modern world, are making it very hard for themselves to win, and the Greens are filling that vacuum in seats like this.
I think you've got another thing going on, which is that over the past 20 years, politicians have become increasingly professionalised in the way they've dealt with the media, and that's meant they've started to look slick, they've started to look very scripted, and at the same time, voters have become incredibly media savvy, and I think have got very cynical, and they're looking for politicians who appear authentic. And I think that the two major parties have largely failed to match that evolution in the way that people understand politics.
Interesting. Is Shorten not authentic? Policy.
I think the crowd is right. It is about policies. It is about politicians talking about policies and talking really honestly about policies. And until the two major parties recognise that and start acting on it, that bleeding is going to continue.
Okay. Quickly, who's going to win on Saturday and by how many seats?
Oh, look, I stand with the conventional wisdom. I think that the Liberals will get over the line just probably by a good 10 seats. But I would add to what Lachie said before. These are very bad times for conventional wisdom.
Lachie, very quickly, who do you think will win on Saturday?
I think Turnbull wins. Labor maybe picks up 6-8 seats. Doesn't feel like they do well. But the big story will be independent, how many people vote for independents around the country.
All right. Thank you to both our gentlemen here on stage. And that is all that we actually have time for tonight. Make sure you join us tomorrow live.